as Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Vixen, Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen. Whoa. Do you recall
the most famous reindeer? Joe.
Every Christmas.
That's all. Come on, everybody. Y'all can come in. We finna get ready to get started on our service this morning. Welcome to Gethsemane Missionary Baptist Church. Y'all come on in. We finna have some church. So glad to see little Jim. I see him over there. Jim, good to see you, brother. All righty. Come on, let's get the Lord a hand praise. Come on, let's get the Lord a hand praise. Thank him for being so good to you. Thank him for waking you up this morning, bringing you out to the house of worship. Let's worship the Lord in service this day. Come on, y'all. Let's get the Lord a hand praise again. That was for you. Now give the Lord a hand praise. Thank him for waking you up this morning, letting you see another day. I thank him for letting me see another birthday. I'm 74 years old. I just thank the Lord for being there. God has been good to me for 74 years, y'all. I'm proud. I'm proud to be 74 years old. God has been good to me. And I'm just crazy enough to give him all the praise, because this wasn't me. It was him that brought me all this way. I thank him for my health and strength. I thank him for blessing me. And I know y'all got something to thank the Lord for, too. Now get on your feet and tell the Lord thank you. Stand up and give the Lord a hand praise. I know God's been good to you. I know he has. He's been good to all of us. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God from whom all blessings flow.
Amen. Can you hear me? Our scripture will be coming from Psalms 1. Blessed is the man that walk not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor sit in the way of sinners, nor sit in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law does he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf shall not wither, and whatsoever he does shall prosper. The godly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind drives away. Therefore the godly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knoweth the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. May the Lord add a blessing to reading and hearing of his word.
Amen. May we bow our heads. Kind gracious Heavenly Father, we first just want to say thank you for allowing us to see another day, Lord. Lord, a day that we've never seen before. Lord, this day, Lord, we just ask that you would just be with us in the midst of this service, Lord. Lord, we would ask that you would just meet us wherever our needs need to be met, Lord. Lord, some of us come in here because we're sick. Some of us come in here, Lord, just to hear word from you, Lord, just to get us through the week, Lord. Lord, some people here, Lord, are just need a healing touch, Lord. Just need a calming voice, Lord. Lord, let that smile from an usher, Lord, or let a song from the choir, or let something said from our pastor, Lord, touch our hearts and minds, Lord, that we might be better leaving out than we were when we walked in this morning, Lord. Lord, we ask that not only did you build us in this service, Lord, did we ask you just carry us throughout the whole week, Lord. Lord, not just build us, Lord, let us carry you with us wherever we go, Lord. Lord, we ask that everything that we do and say today, Lord, be uplifting and holy and righteous unto your word, Lord. We ask that we do everything decent and order in your, Lord, in your name, Lord. Lord, we ask you touch every auxiliary that's open in your name today, Lord. Lord, we ask that we would just all be willing participants in today's service, Lord. Lord, we know that this service would be uplifting and blessed, Lord, if we all lift our hands, Lord, if we all lift our voices, Lord, and if we all are on one accord, Lord, serving one God, Lord. Lord, we ask that you would just touch all of us, Lord, and if there's anyone here today, Lord, that doesn't know you and the pardon of their sins, Lord, we ask that this day they choose to serve you. Lord, we ask these and all other blessings in thy son Jesus' name. Amen.
Come and go to that land. Come and go to that land. Come and go to that land where I'm bound. Where I'm bound. Come and go to that land. Come and go to that land. Come and go to that land where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Come and go to that land. Come and go to that land. Come and go to that land where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Come and go to that land. Come and go to that land. Come and go to that land where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Peace and joy in that land. Peace and joy in that land. Peace and joy in that land where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Peace and joy in that land. Peace and joy in that land. Peace and joy is in that land where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Nothing but happiness in that land. Nothing but happiness in that land. Nothing but happiness is in that land where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Nothing but happiness in that land. Nothing but happiness in that land. Nothing but happiness is in that land where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Come and go to that land. Oh, come and go to that land. Come and go to that land. Where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Oh, come and go to that land. Come and go to that land. Come and go to that land. Where I'm bound.
Amen. Y'all sleep this morning.
All righty. All right. Come on, y'all. What time is it? What time is it? It's time to praise the Lord. Come on. It's time to praise the Lord.
Oh, it's time to praise the Lord.
Oh, it's time to praise the Lord. Oh, it's time to praise the Lord. Come on, let's praise the Lord, y'all. Come on. To praise the Lord. To praise the Lord. Oh, it's time to praise the Lord. Oh, it's time to praise the Lord. I just wanted to do a little verse for that. In the choir, y'all turn it over in the hands of the choir.
All right, now. There you go, Dick. There you go, Dick. Y'all got it now.
Let us say amen. Let us say amen again. We are grateful to God for allowing us to see yet another day. Amen. And now we'll be blessed with a song from our choir.
Check, check. Can we give God a praise, will you? Amen. God is a good God all the time. No matter what it looks like or what it may feels like, God is good. Can you just hug your neighbor and just tell your neighbor it's just good to see you this morning? Can you do that? Hallelujah. Come on, come on. Why don't you just go across the aisle and some people that you ain't never seen before, just say, neighbor, it's just good to see you. It's just good to see you. It's just good to see you. It's the last third Sunday of the year. Amen. Just hug them. Amen. I'm telling you. Amen. Amen. Come on, just give God one more hand clap of praise, will you? Amen. It's down through the years, God's been good to us. Amen. Just lift this song as we get ready to go further in the service and just lift your voices with us. Down through the years, oh Lord, God's been good to me. Everybody say down. I wish I could get some help here. Oh Lord, God's been. Think about January to the present. Oh, down. Oh, God's been. I come to tell you that God. Think about it today. All of my life, oh, God's been. I come to tell you that all God's been good to me. Well, oh, oh, God's been. I come to tell you that. Think about it, church. Think about it. Mm-hmm. My mind is. Come on, y'all know it. I'm gonna hold my. I'm on my way. Going on. Come on, church, and say it. Trouble in my way. I gotta cry sometime. So much trouble. I gotta cry sometime. I laid awake at night. I laid awake at night. I laid awake at night. Jesus will fix it. After a while, you know what you gotta do. A hold to his hand. Hey, a God's unchanging hand. Everybody say hold. Come on, church. Oh God, God's unchanging. Well, I've been your hopes on things in. praise.
Let us say amen. Amen. Let us say amen again. We thank God for God's goodness and God's mercy and God's grace. The Lord's been good to us. I said the Lord's been good to us. Better than we deserve. Amen. We are so grateful to God for this being a day of worship, a day that the Lord has made, and we are to rejoice and be glad therein. Amen. We thank God for God's goodness, God's mercy, and God's grace. Not this time, if there's anyone here worshiping with us for the very first time, if this is the very first time you've been in here to worship, we ask that you stand, give us your name, amen, your church home if you have one, and remain standing so that we may give you a GNBC welcome.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
It's a blessing to be in the house of the Lord on this morning. Amen.
Amen.
God is good.
Yes.
Amen. This is my first time. I came out yesterday for the Christmas dinner, amen, and I was invited by Sally.
Amen.
I go to the gym with her, and I just thank God that she invited me out. I enjoyed every minute of the dinner on yesterday, and I'm truly already enjoying the service on this morning. I also know Sheila. I worked with Sheila for some years at GM.
Amen. Amen.
So she had invited me out before Sally did, but I never came.
All right.
I just thank God for invitation. Truly, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I just thank God for being saved and sanctified and filled with the precious Holy Spirit.
All right.
Amen. Thank you. Amen.
Amen. Let us welcome our guests. To our visitor, we thank God for your presence, and we thank God that you was with us on yesterday. Amen. And encourage you to come back to be with us on today. Amen. So we're thankful to God for you being here, being a part of our worship experience. We just ask that you enjoy yourself, and you are at home. Amen. At this time, it is a time in which all of us can be blessed. It is giving time. Amen. Amen. It's giving time. This is Christmas season, right? Amen. It is giving time, so we want to prepare our hearts and minds now to be obedient to the Lord and to be a blessing to others if the Lord has blessed all of us. Amen. So we're going to ask now, as our officers are coming and coming forth, that we prepare our hearts and minds for the giving arrangement and the giving moment. Amen. We're going to ask for you all to stand as we ask God's blessings upon our giving, and after which you will follow the directions of our ushers. Dear gracious God, we are so thankful for what you've blessed us with monetarily, Lord. We thank you for the income. We thank you, Lord, for what you allow us to accumulate, what you allow us to earn. We ask now that you bless it, multiply it in the name of Jesus, O Lord. Bless it, O Lord. Lord, that all carnalness is taken out. Bless the minds that will be obedient to your word and will give to be a blessing and to be obedient. Touch everyone who gives. Bless them, O Lord. Challenge those who have it to give but will not give. And bless those who have a desire to give but do not have it to give. We ask your blessings in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I'm going to ask you to come around. The two gold trays is for our mission offering. The basket in the middle is for our tithes and offering. Let us say amen. Let us say amen again. I want to start off by saying that on Friday, myself, Reverend Samples, and a few others from our church family, Sister Deborah, we were all blessed to witness the 100th birthday of Mother Gracie Williams. Amen. We got a chance to have some cake with her, sing happy birthday to her. It was just a blessing. So we just wanted to say that on behalf of the pastor, that GNBC was there with her to celebrate her 100th birthday. Amen. Amen. It's a blessing. Amen. There's not enough words to say about yesterday. We had a wonderful turnout. Amen. Over 300 from the community came in yesterday. Amen. Amen. And so we are definitely grateful to God. We are thankful to God for all of you that played a part, for those that invited individuals, that brought individuals, that came out to mingle with our brothers and sisters. It was definitely a blessing. I do want to share that we always try to make certain that we have more than enough. And so we did have more than enough. And so what that means is that if you hadn't cooked anything or planned on cooking anything, you don't have to. There is some food that's left over. And so we're just going to, after service is over, we're going to have you go back there and eat. Now, I can't promise you what's all not there. Amen. And I can't promise you that they're going to get your plate full, but there's definitely there, and it's there until it's out. Amen. So we want you to be mindful on the house. Amen. Amen. On the house. Amen. For those that will come out, definitely as soon as service is over with, you can go back there, get your plate, and fellowship with your brothers and sisters, and you can save a few dollars. Amen. For going out to eat. Amen. Amen. You can eat here at the church. Do want to say, as I was sharing during our vision informational last week, about the importance of making certain that when we have offerings, particularly that is raised for the mission offering, that at the end of the physical year, calendar year, that we don't have a huge surplus. Amen. We give that money to be given to those in need. It does not make sense to have $6,000 or $7,000 that we're carrying from 1 year to the next year. That means there's some work we haven't done that we need to do. And so as we're coming down now towards the end of the year, we're looking to make some depletions to the mission. And one of the things that we are doing, there was a family that I got word of that was homeless, a mother with children. She had an opportunity to come by yesterday. She had an opportunity to eat. And then we went into our mission to be a blessing to her and her family. Amen. Amen. Now, there is a 70-some-year-old lady who lives in Kalamazoo. Kalamazoo is one of the sanctuary cities. There's a church in Kalamazoo that houses those seeking asylum from the situations that's going on in their particular countries. They are here. She's been here for a long time. She's been doing well in the community, and she has been literally stuck in a church for the last 2.5 years. For if she walks outside of the church, the ICE agents will arrest her and deport her back to her homeland of Pakistan, in which has a bounty on her head as soon as she lands. And so while I was Thursday, had opportunity to meet with other pastors from around the state, along with the governor, there was a pastor that shared her story. And immediately I told him that our mission was going to do something to help them as they help her. And so we're going to get together and we're going to send a donation to the church that's helping her. Amen. And then our other will be, there's a church in Monroe, Michigan that has a homeless shelter. And I've been there, and we're going to also send money to them to help them do what they're doing. And we're just saying, God bless you. And we're joining in partnership. Amen. And so this is what it's all about. And there's no doubt to me that we will continue to be blessed as we as a church continue to be a blessing to others. And so I just wanted you to understand this is what we're doing with some of the resources that in our mission as our year comes down to an end. So this is how we're going to be blessed and blessings to others. Amen. Just wanted you to know. I would never give names out, but I just wanted you to know what we're doing. Now, the homeless shelter, I will definitely share the name. That's fine. But as far as the other individuals that we've helped out, I just wanted to share with you their story and their predicament, but to let you know that this is what it's all about. And so this is what we're going to do. We want to remind everyone that on next Sunday, we will begin worship at 9. Amen. We have one worship service at 9 next Sunday. I already informed the 8 o'clockers, told them if they come at 8, they're going to be early. Amen. And if you come at 10, you're going to be late. Amen. So coordinate yourselves. Get up an hour earlier. So we're here at 9 o'clock so that we can have a worship. Our young folks are preparing a play that was written by one of our new family members of our church. Amen. And so we want to definitely see the play unfold. As a matter of fact, I think they are rehearsing now. Amen. I believe they'll be rehearsing in the downstairs. So I believe that many of our young folks are down there rehearsing and preparing for the play on next week. Amen. So we want you to be mindful again. 9 o'clock, one service, When we come to the fifth Sunday, we'll go back to our 8 and 10 o'clock worship experience. But this is for our holiday season, our holiday time. And so we just want you to be mindful of these announcements and any other announcements that is listed in the bulletin. We want to thank those who also believe today is the last day for our Toys for Joy. Amen. Amen. So we want to definitely help. And I do want to say that we also reach out just beyond this area, the school where our children attend. We've also reached out to their schools, and we have families that's away from here that we're helping out. And so I just want you to know that GNBC's reach is just beyond this little circumference. Amen? And that's, again, the way the Lord is going to continue to bless us as we reach out. Because at the end of the day, it doesn't matter where folks live. If there's a need and we can help them, we should help them. Amen? Amen. So I just wanted to give some transparency to you and just to let you know what we are doing and how the Lord is blessing us. Our new lapel pins are in with a new logo. Amen. If you haven't seen them, take a look. Amen. Amen. And so we are so grateful to God for that. We want you to be mindful of all the other announcements that you see listed here in your bulletin to govern yourselves accordingly. And now we will be blessed with another selection from our Gap Choir.
Man, this song here is a good song that kind of touches your heart. How many have been through some trying times from January to the present time? Some trying times. Song says, I've been through too much not to worship him. Anybody want to worship him today? Anybody want to praise the Lord today? Amen. All the things.
All the things that I've been through.
You can feel my pain.
You can feel my pain.
What I had to go through.
What I had to go through to get here.
You'll never understand my praise.
You'll never understand my praise.
Because my worship
is for real.
Because my worship
is for real.
Come on, say it again. You don't know.
All the things that I've been through.
You can feel my pain.
You can feel my pain.
What I had to go through.
What I had to go through to get here.
You'll never understand my praise.
You'll never understand my praise.
Because my worship
Come on, say it. Because my worship.
Because my worship.
My worship.
My worship is for real.
Come on, let's say that one more time. One more time. You don't know my story.
You don't know my story.
All the things.
All the things that I've been through.
Come on. You can feel my pain.
You can feel my pain.
What I had to go through.
What I had to go through to get here.
Who am I talking to? You'll never understand my praise.
You'll never.
Don't
try to figure it out.
Because my worship.
Because my worship.
My worship.
My worship is for real.
Come on, say it again. Because my worship.
Because my worship.
My worship.
My worship is for real.
Come on and give God the praise out of your mouth and tell him how good he's been. Come on, come on. Don't you let the devil shut your mouth up. You've been through too much not to give him a praise, not to lift your hands up and give God honor for what he's done and what he's going to do. Come on, church. I've been through too much. To worship him. Who am I talking to this morning? To worship him. Come on, say it again. I've been through too much. I dare you just to think about what you've been through. It's some things that you've been through, you can't even tell your neighbor to. You can't even tell your neighbor about it. But there's one person that you can tell about what you've been through. It's the Lord our Savior, Jesus the Christ. Think about it. I've been through too much.
I've been through too much.
Lord, have mercy. Come on, say it again. I've been through too much.
I've been through too much.
To worship him.
To worship.
Come on, say it again. I've been through too much.
I've been through too much.
Not to worship him.
Not
to worship him.
Worship.
Come on, all over this room, just say. Say hallelujah.
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 My worship is for real.
My worship is for real.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
My worship is for real.
My worship is for real.
Say thank you, Jesus.
Thank hey, you, hey. Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
My worship is for real.
My worship is for real.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I praise you.
Lord, I praise you.
My worship is for real.
My worship.
Let's take it up. Say hallelujah.
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 My worship is for real. Come on, say it. Say hallelujah.
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 My worship is for real. Come on.
My worship is for real.
Say yeah.
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 Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Say, say yeah. Because my worship,
is glorious.
Come on, say it. Because my worship,
is glorious.
Come on, tell your neighbor. Come on, sing it with me. Because my worship,
is for real.
Come on, hallelujah. Because my worship,
is for real.
Come on, give him a praise. Don't you let the devil shut your mouth up. You've been through too much not to give him praise, not to give him glory. The devil is a liar. Open up your mouth. Give him praise. Give him honor. Hallelujah.
As we gather for prayer, I'm going to ask the Davises to come and stand in an intercession for Deacon Carl. We know a God that is able. I said we know a God that is able. We've seen it for ourselves. And so we're going to ask them to come and stand in for him in intercession. And we want to continue to pray for him at noon every day. Call his name and say a prayer for him. Amen. Amen. We come trusting. We come believing. Amen. Come on. Amen. 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 This is the family here. We trusting. And we're believing God. All the miracles are not in the Bible. There are some that are happening right now. I said there are some miracles that are happening right now. And so we want to touch and we want to agree on behalf of our brother what God is able to do. And we're putting it in God's hands. And anyone else, we're putting it in God's hands, trusting God and believing God, because God has the final word.
Amen. Prayer shall always be the highest priority. Amen. It'll take me all day to tell you what I've been through, but just a few seconds to tell you who brought me through. Gracious God, our Father, which art in heaven, we come today, Lord, first to say thank you. Father, we thank you for allowing us to see a day that we've never seen before. Father God, we thank you for you allowing us to wake up this morning and to make it to your house of praise one more time. Father God, and since we made it here, it just makes sense to praise your name. Since we made it here, it just makes sense to give you thanks. Since we made it here, it just makes sense to give you all the honor and all the glory, Father God. You deserve it all, and we give it all to you. Father God, we asking you right now to touch. Father God, we asking you right now to heal. Father God, we asking you right now to comfort. Father God, we asking you right now to strengthen. Father God, we asking for your presence to be in the midst of your people right now. Father God, we need you more than ever right now. Keep the everlasting arms of grace and mercy wrapped around us right now. Father God, continue to shine your love down on us right now. Father God, we can't make it without you. Father God, we can't breathe without you. Father God, we can't live without you. Father God, we ask you right now, Father God, to continue to build us where we're broken and continue to strengthen us where we're weak. Father God, build us where we're broken, strengthen us where we're weak. Father God, we pray that you always will be in our life. We pray that you keep your hedge of protection around us. Father God, we pray that you keep your everlasting mercy and your everlasting grace in our house and in our families. Father God, we asking right now, Father God, for forgiveness. Father God, anytime we wrong you, Father God, forgive us. Anytime we wrong our brother, Father, forgive us. Anytime we wrong our friend, Father, forgive us. Anytime we wrong our neighbor, Father, forgive us. Anytime we wrong our brother, forgive us. Anytime we wrong our mothers, forgive us. Anytime we wrong our sisters, forgive us. God, we praying right now for forgiveness. Father God, we praying for forgiveness. Father God, they may not need, I need it. Father God, forgive and forgive right now. Father God, we haven't been all that you asked us to be, Father God, but we better than we've been. Father God, we ask you right now, Father God, to touch Deacon Carl's body. Father God, touch. We know you're able, Father God, you did it before, so touch. And touch him in a mighty special way. Heal him and heal him in a mighty special way. Cover him and cover him in a mighty special way. Love him and love him in a mighty special way. Father God, keep the Davis family so close, Father God, that one don't fall without the other, Father God. Keep them as only you can. Bless them as only you do. Love them continuously, Father. For your love will last. For your love will outlast all hate. For your love will outlast all jealousy. For your love will outlast all envy. For your love will outlast all discontentment. For your love will outlast. Father God, we're praying for your love. Father God, we need your love. Father God, we desire your love. Father God, we want your love. Father God, love and love right now. Keep and keep right now. Bless this hand that I hold. Father God, I don't know what they're going through, but you know. Father God, I don't have an answer, but you got them all. So Father God, we asking you, Father God, to answer prayers on today. We asking you, Father God, to deliver sinners on today. We asking you, Father God, to make us better than we was yesterday on today. And we'll be so careful and so mindful to give you all the praise, to give you all the glory, all the days of our life. In our son Jesus' name, we submit these prayers unto you. And all God's people say together, amen, amen, and amen. If you have not yet been anointed and desire to do so, please remain standing. If you not have yet been anointed and desire to be.
Let us say amen. Well, it is preaching time, and you probably figured out by now, I'm not preaching. Amen. We have been full all week. Had, as you all know, I have a group of doctoral students that I'm mentoring through, and I had to do some last-minute grades turning in for them that I was not aware of until the last minute. And so between that and Bible study and everything else, and I'll just be honest, every once in a while, pastor needs to hear a word. Amen. Amen. I have not fooled myself to thinking that the only preaching that can come forth is by me. Amen. And so the Lord has blessed us with an arsenal of preachers who can and will preach God's word. And this just happens to be one of these Sundays that I grabbed Dr. Nelson and said, I know your schedule is busy, but we need you at 10. Amen. And so I'm not certain about the rest of her month, but I knew this day was good. Amen. And so she's going to bless us this morning. So the title and the text is hers. Amen. But the proclamation will come from her and not from me. Amen. I'll be willing to say amen. Amen. And I just ask that you, my brothers and sisters, open up your hearts. We thank Dr. Nelson for what she has meant to our church family. Amen. Amen. She's been a blessing to us. And we thank God for her. And as you all know, she's from Third New Hope, and not certain what will happen as changes happen at Third New Hope. And so while we have her still, amen, we're going to utilize her as much as we can. Amen. We thank God for the ministry that she brings to and the passion she brings to the church, collective church, but particularly our church, and sharing her gifts and graces here. And so we are just grateful for her to make time in her schedule to write us in. And so we're going to hear a word from the Lord. The choir is going to come and bless us one more again. Amen. And then the next voice will be that of our preacher for this morning, the Reverend Dr. Jacqueline Nelson. Amen. Let us pray for her. Let us pray with her as she delivers us a relevant word this morning. God bless you.
Just ask your neighbor, say, neighbor, whose side are you on? Whose side? I want to know what side you're on. What side? And it should have been, I'm on the Lord's side. I'm on the Lord's side. Who's on the Lord's side? Come on, help us have a little church. Come on. Come on and clap your hands. Just give me just a little bit more volume on this mic. Come on and clap your hands. Here we go. I've been running. I've been running. Oh, running for a long time. Your time is winding up. You better make up your mind. Getting late in the evening. Sun is going down. Better get it right, get it right. Why you have time? I want to know. Who's on the Lord's side? Where do you stay? Who's on the Lord's side? Where do you stay? On the Lord's side, I'm on. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm on the Lord's side. I'm on. I'm gonna say it one more time. I'm trying to get some help. I've been running. I've been running. Running for a long time. Your time is winding up. You better make up your mind. Get laid in the evening. Sun is going down. Better get it right while you have time. I want to know who's on the Lord's side. Where do you stay? Who's on the Lord's side? Where do you stay? Who's on the Lord's side? I'm on the Lord. I'm on the Lord. I'm on the Lord's side. Now listen. It may be somebody that's been sitting down all day. And you probably looked at them and said, didn't you come to praise the Lord today? You probably looked at them to see what kind of side they were on. I just want you just to look at them this morning. Look them straight in their eye. And tell them these two words. Get up. If you're on the Lord's side, help it quiet. Say, get up. If you're on the Lord's side, get on up. If you're on the Lord's side, get on up. If you're on the Lord's side, get up. If you're on the Lord's side, get on up. If you're on the Lord's side, I'm on the Lord. I'm on the Lord. I'm on the Lord's side. Come on and clap your hands. Like the devil's in between them. Come on. Clap your hands. Now it's starting to sound like Gethsemane. I want all the sopranos get ready. Come on. Clap your hands. Come on, sopranos, get up. If. Come on, soprano. I hear you. If. Altos, you ready? Clap your hand. Come on, altos, get up. If you're on the Lord's side. Come on, alto. If you're on the Lord's side. Clap your hands. Come on, sinners. Get up. If you're the Lord's side. Get on up. If you're on the Lord's side. Everybody clap your hands. Sunday of the year. Everybody clap your hands. Come on. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Now back when I used to go to the cabaret. Don't you judge me. The good news is I just came to a Holy Ghost party now. And said my dance has changed from doing the boogaloo, from doing the holy dance. Now, give it to me on the one and break it down. Here we go. Now, for those of you that's not scared, I believe I got at least 5 witnesses out here, and we're moving, that'll help me dance under the Holy Ghost. Would you help me dance this morning? I said, would you help me dance this morning? Well, I need you to get in the highways. I need you to get in the highways. All the people not scared. All the people that's not scared. You can come on up. You can come on up in the front if you want to. Y'all ready? 1, 2, everybody, let's go. Everybody, let's go. Can't see ya, let's go. Here we go, I'm on. Come on and clap your hands. I like the devil's in between them. This the last third Sunday of the year. How you want to go out and praise them?
Of God, say amen. Amen. Come on, say amen again. Come on and give God some praise. That's if you're on the Lord's side. If he's been good to you, you ought to give him some praise. If you on his side, better yet, if he on your side, you ought to give him some praise. You know you ain't supposed to be here. They tried to take you out last year. But look at God. He lets you see another year, another December. And so you might as well praise him. Because when you get to heaven, that's all you're going to do anyhow. So get yourself some practice on what you're going to do in eternity. And tell the Lord, thank you for keeping me. Thank you for living for me. Thank you. I got food on my table. I got a roof over my head. I got a portion of my health and my strength. So I just came to celebrate the goodness of the Lord. You might as well praise him. I see them have to preach because the praise so strong up in here because he's been good. Real good. Real good. Hallelujah. 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 I thank you, Jesus, for every miracle. I thank you, Jesus, for every covering. I thank you, Jesus. I look on the mother's board and they still here. I thank you, Jesus. I look at the deacon board. They still here. I thank you, Jesus. I look at Pastor Duckworth. He's still here. We have so much to thank God for. So bless his name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I got two more services. I plan to do this all day. I'm not tired yet. I got one more shout left. You just gotta praise your way through it. You can't cry all the time. Sometimes you gotta praise your way through it. I know it's rough, but can you still praise him? I know it's hard sometimes, but can you still say hallelujah? I know you might have lost a couple of things, but is he still worthy to be praised? week. I can say, may the Lord watch. I can get a benediction right now. Amen. Amen. Some fire you probably don't need to step in. Amen. 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 How good the Lord is. How good the Lord is. So, some of y'all been holding on to that for a while. We figured you get a little permission today to go let that out. Amen. Amen. You try to hold in and shout, you'll get a headache. Amen. You need to let that out for the folk that don't know what it's all about. Amen. Amen. Visitor over there, I would say excuse me, but this is just how we roll. Amen. This is just how we roll. This is how we roll. Amen. Amen. There's somebody liable to take you, watch yourself, because somebody will take off running around here. Because if Carl was here, he'd be the one doing the running. Amen. 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 All right, I'm gonna do what I was assigned to do. Amen. I'm going to do what I was assigned to do. I'm a blessed woman of God. I promise y'all, I'm a blessed woman of God. I'm blessed because I can shout at 8 o'clock at 3rd New Hope. I can get on 94 and come over to Gethsemane and shout some more. Amen. I'm a blessed woman of God. Amen. I got two churches. Amen. Amen. I got two churches. Amen. Amen. And I feel good at every one of them. Amen. Amen, 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 amen. This is an awesome, awesome church. I'm telling you, this is an awesome, awesome, awesome. I used to think y'all was a well-kept secret in Westland. Y'all ain't no secret no more. Y'all blessing people across the world. Amen, 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 amen. You ain't got to be no great cathedral stretching all 900 blocks to do that. God is doing something miraculous right up in GMBC. And I won't take it back. What he's done, he has some more that he's going to do right through GMBC. Amen. 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 I'm glad. Amen. Amen. In my 4 years of being here, I done seen this church do more than some churches have done in 25, 30 years. In 4 years that I've been here. And so if God can do all of that, can you just imagine what he's getting ready to do? That's just a foretaste. You know what a foretaste is? A foretaste is like when, you know, I ain't no cook now, but a foretaste. You know when they used to bake them cakes and they used to make them little tester cakes? And they make that little bitty small cake before they make the big cake. And they let you taste that little cake. It was a foretaste of the big cake. This just a foretaste of the big cake. Amen. All right. All right. There is a word from the Lord today. To Pastor Duckworth, I'm so grateful to you. This is my brother beloved. I'm talking about my brother beloved. And I have a pastor. But when I tell you, I can pick up my phone and I can call. He called me Nelson, and I call him Duckworth. Nelson, Duckworth, look at here. I'm da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And he say, da-da-da-da. And it's all good. It's all good. It's all good. So we have a pastor par excellence right here. Amen. 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 My husband and my sister are here with me today, and my poor husband, this is second round. He done. He done got confused. We was in the car. He said, okay, you preaching at 8 o'clock at Third New Hope. Yep. Then you preaching 10 o'clock at Gethsemane. Yep. And he said, and Jamel preaching at 12 o'clock at Third New Hope. That's my grandson. I said, no, he's singing at 12 o'clock. We done run the poor man so much today, he don't know if he coming or going. But God bless him. Real good. Real, real good. Real good. Real good. Driving Miss Daisy. Amen. 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 He's still driving Miss Daisy. I thank the Lord for it. I thank the Lord for it. He going to take me to the store. I'm thank the Lord. Amen. 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 There is a word from the Lord today from the book of Luke. Luke chapter 2, verses 36 through 38. And in there you'll find the following words. It says, there was also a prophet, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was a great age, having lived with her husband 7 years after her marriage. Then as a widow to the age of 84, she never left the temple, but worshiped there with fasting and prayer day and night. At that moment, she came and began to praise God and to speak about the child to all who were looking for the redemption of Jerusalem. For a few minutes, I just want to talk about a life well lived. A life well lived. Amen. When is the last time you took a look at your life to see if you are living in a way that would be pleasing in the eyes of God?
My Lord. All right. My Lord. All right.
What can you see or what are you doing to demonstrate that you take serious the fact that your life belongs to God? We are the people who profess to belong to Christ. We are the ones that made the choice to give our lives to Christ. And I just believe that Christ desires for each of us, whether we have accepted his redemptive work or not, to have a life that is well lived. For those who have not made the connection to Christ yet, the desire is still there for you to have that type of life. If you want a life well lived, then you must position yourself to get it. If we have accepted Christ as our personal Savior, then we should demonstrate to the world around us that we've done it. I just feel and believe that our lives, if they are going to be well lived, has to be based on something deeper than what we see on the surface.
Right.
See, living life for something deeper or something more meaningful has to be our goal.
Yeah.
If we are the only ones who benefits from what we are doing in our life, then we may want to assess whether or not we are demonstrating a life well lived.
That's right.
I want to talk about this today because in this season of our remembering the birth of our Savior, it is also time for us to do some self-reflecting.
Yeah.
It's a time for us to do some introspection. Time for us to ascertain whether or not we are depicting a life well lived. We live in a time when people can live their lives all types of ways. We can create a life on social media, and we can be whatever we desire to be.
Come on.
Today, I can be Rem Nelson.
Yeah.
Tomorrow I can be whoever I want to be on social media. I can go out there and I can make all these kind of statements. I can make my marriage look like it's the best thing in the world. Why, if you take me off Facebook, my marriage tore up from the floor. But I can go out on Facebook and I can be this great star. And if I get on Snapchat, I can make my skin look nice and I can make my hair look wavy. I can be anything I want to be on social media. But the question becomes, but real life for those who profess Christ or desire to has to be lived from the inside out if it's going to be well.
That's right.
If we don't talk about this, we run the risk of people starting to believe this superficial life and this superficial lifestyle that they've created, and they'll start to believe that that's the real them.
That's right. Come on. Come on.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
See, in our passage of scripture today, we encounter a woman who I believe teaches us how to live life well. See, our children and many of us are in need of examples of people, models for living life well. See, all types of people, these types of people, brother, are rare, and when you find them, you ought to cherish them. See, Anna is believed to be one of the Bible's most unusual women introduced at the end of the birth narrative. See, this story concludes the six stories which surround the narratives and the miraculous births of both John and Jesus. Yeah. See, the other stories are the stories of Zechariah and Elizabeth and Mary and Joseph. And then you have Simeon and Anna.
Yeah.
See, Anna arrives at the purification of Mary, Joseph, and Jesus in the temple.
Yeah.
See, 40 days after Jesus' birth is when they arrive at the temple. It's a scene repeated over and over in Israelite culture, for the law required a sacrifice of a lamb or two pigeons or two doves after a son's birth. You know, it's kind of like they had on the Day of Atonement or other days that you had to bring certain sacrifices for your sin. And I'm going to stick a pin there. Ain't you glad that we ain't got to bring no more turtle doves to the altar to ask God to forgive us for our sins? It wouldn't be no more turtle doves left. It wouldn't be no more pigeons left. It wouldn't be no more doves left. But because of what Christ has done, the doves can live, the pigeons can live, and we can live a life that's right before God. See, what happens is, see, if this purification could be done only in Jerusalem.
Uh-huh.
See, and so it was necessary for the family to make the journey. See, the firstborn was regarded as belonging to the Lord. And for the Israelites, the firstborn was made particularly significant while it was a memorial to the Lord's wonderful deliverance of the children of Israel. It was a foreshadow of a greater deliverance by the very child who was brought to the temple that day. See, when we typically hear this story, it comes from the perspective of Simeon, who actually has a dialogue with Mary and Joseph regarding the baby Jesus. See, a dialogue that's guided by the Holy Spirit, which brings them there in fulfillment of a prayer that he would see the Messiah before he died. He is described as a man who was righteous and devout. And not to take away anything from Simeon today, but I want to focus on a woman. I want to focus on a woman who is far off on the side of the temple. She's not speaking, but she's listening. And when she's listening with ears that have been anticipating that one day when she came to church, that the miraculous would happen. I just want to know today, did anybody come to church, kind of slipped up in here, eased up in here, and today you looking for a miracle? I just want to poll the room today to see if anybody came up in here. I want something different today. I want a different encounter today. Every now and then, if you ease up in the temple long enough, Jesus will slide up in here and do something that we ain't never seen done before.
So now
listen. See, like Anna.
Yeah.
See, like Anna, some of you have been living with anticipatory hope.
Yeah, come on.
You've been living with anticipatory hope that one day you would encounter the miraculous. Yeah. So you try to do the right thing. You've been visiting the sick. You've been feeding the hungry. You've been doing other things that some folk don't even know that you're doing. You live with a hope that Christ would one day make a miraculous entrance into your situation. If we would be honest, some people will sit here and go, or they would be on live stream, but still have that hope for an encounter with the Christ of the Bible. That's why I wanted to take a look at Anna today. You know her. She's the person who comes to the temple to worship. They don't make a whole lot of noise. Oh, but they in here. You don't know their names, but you see them every week. Sometimes he or she will leave before the benediction because they don't want to get a chance to talk to nobody. But they slide up in here. They come a little bit late sometimes. Ease up in the balcony. Go up back behind the choir. But they up in here. They don't make a lot of noise because they ain't in here to be seen. They want to see Jesus. They ain't trying to see you. So they slide up in the temple every now and then. They come up in here because they expect something. They believe something. They got something on the inside that tells them to press your way. Get your way to the temple. Because I want to give you a life that's going to be well lived.
Come on.
So they come. They're here with the hope that today will be the day that they have that encounter with Christ.
Yeah.
There's something on the inside that is craving something at a different level of worship. Anna, I tell you, is a representative figure of so many of us and that so many of us can relate to. But who is this obscure woman, this unusual lady that kind of is on the sideline of the story? She's a woman whose story is pinned at the end of somebody else's story, a story that if you're not careful, if you're not looking for it, you might miss. The Bible describes her as depending on what your translation is. It calls her a prophet, or some translation says she's a prophetess. It says that a prophet, the gift of prophecy, was sometimes, time to time, it was bestowed upon women as well as men. I know that scares some of y'all, but there are some women prophets. The Bible says that he bestowed the office of prophet. Not prophetess.
Yeah.
The office of prophet on some women. You remember Miriam in the Old Testament. You remember Deborah, don't you? You remember Isaiah's wife. How about Huldah? How about the four daughters of Philip? See, a prophet is an individual who is regarded as being in contact with the divine being and is said to speak on the entity's behalf, serving in an intermediary with humanity by delivering messages or teachings from the supernatural source and giving it to other people. Let me put it this way. Every now and then, God will call somebody to rise up in your life. They'll come into your life, ease up beside you, and speak a word that you know that it came from God. They'll speak a word in your life that'll change your very course on life. Isn't anybody here that ever had an opportunity to get a word from a prophet? You know it wasn't them. They don't even look like they could talk like that, but they got a word from the Lord, and when they blessed you with that word, your whole life changed.
I'm just saying
what I'm saying. You can take it or not, but I'm just saying what I'm saying. But see, on this particular day, Anna doing what she would usually do in the temple, and she overhears a conversation but she has been, that she's been listening for probably most of her life. She overheard a conversation. And see, again, like many of us, she came to church. She came as usual. But today, something different happened. I wonder if anybody here today is like Anna, wanting something different in their life. You want a life well lived. You desire an Anna experience. And so let's look at Anna and see what lessons we can learn from Anna that can benefit us on our quest to a life well lived. The first thing, if we're going to have a life well lived, that Anna shows us and the lesson we can get from it, if you're going to have a life well lived, you're going to have to learn to wait on the Lord in spite of your life circumstances. I'm just a realist. I know waiting is just not something we do well. We don't like to wait, because we in this instantaneous world that wants everything right now, waiting is not what many folk want to do.
That's right.
See, let's face it. We would have stopped coming to church, claimed that we were no longer being fed here, and went on our merry little way. Yeah. If we had to wait as long as Anna had to wait, we would have stopped coming to church, said them folk at the church don't know what they're talking about. The pastor keep preaching that stuff, and ain't nothing changing in my life. But here is Anna, a woman who by all things look as if life dealt her a bad hand. She did all the stuff that society told her to do. She got married with the intention of having children, and she especially expected to have a boy child. I mean, she did all this, but in her heart, there was a prayer that even with all of this, in her heart, she knew that the Messiah was going to come one day. She had all the right family. After all, her father's name was Phanuel, and if you look up the meaning of his name means face of God. So every day, every time she called her daddy's name, she had to speak about what was happening on the inside. She called her daddy's name Phanuel, but she was really channeling that one day I'll see the face of God. From all intents and purposes, she had a call. She had to call her father by the name of her hope. Her family life was set up for her to have a life that was well lived. She was from the tribe of Asher, and Asher had the reputation by the time of Moses of having some of the most beautiful women in all of Mediterranean. But a life well lived cannot be based on who your mama is. It can't be based on who your daddy is. It can't be based on who your tribe is. It can't be based on nothing that's outward or superficial. Anna had something deeper on the inside that she was waiting for. Anna had a promise deep down on the inside, and she believed that one day that she would see the Lord. How long will you wait for the promises of God that God has told you? Is some of y'all sitting out here? God has promised you some things, and you ain't got it yet. How long will you stand and wait on your change to come? Your circumstances that you find yourself in, it may not be the best, but yet God has made you some promises. I don't know about you, but I'm standing on the promises of God. I'm waiting on God, and you ought to wait too. The same thing he promised Anna, he promised to us too. He promised us a life well lived. If we can wait through our circumstances, I know that he'll do it, because God made a promise. He said, I'll give you strength. Strength to the weary, and I increase the power of the weak. He made us a promise. He said, if you pass through the waters, I'll be with you. He said, if you don't get too anxious about anything, but pray about everything, that he would give you peace that passes understanding. Isn't anybody in here that gonna wait through their circumstances to get a life well lived? Thank you, Anna, for waiting. Thank you for sitting and setting an example of what life well lived looks like. Thank you for giving us right here in this church examples of what it looks like, what leadership looks like, that has lived a life well, and how to remain strong. So in spite of all of her circumstances, Anna waited on God. Every day, it wasn't sunshine. Every day in your life ain't sunshine either. All things didn't go her way, but yet she waited with a hopeful heart that she would see the glory of the Lord in the land of the living. The Bible says that she was a great age, having lived with her husband 7 years after their marriage, and then was a widow, and now was at the age of 84. Can you imagine what Anna had to wait through? Can you even fathom what this woman with a life well lived had to go through? heaven now and then. I like to sit down with some of my seasoned saints. And I like to get a word from them to see, how did you make it through? What did you have to go through in order to get where you are? To have a life well lived. It's been said that God delays his blessings sometimes to examine where your heart is. He waits on purpose. It's not that he doesn't want to bless you, but he's after a purpose greater than your immediate blessing. God doesn't want to just fix your problems. He wants to transform you in the process because he wants you to have a life well lived. I just need somebody in here that's willing to wait on the Lord through your circumstances so you can get to a life well lived. A life well lived ain't determined by your age. A life well lived is determined by your faith. It ain't dependent on your gender, but it's dependent on whether or not you will believe in your heart what thus saith the Lord.
Come on.
So not only do we benefit from Anna, and the lessons that we get from her is by her ability to wait in spite of her life circumstances. But then another lesson that we get from Anna that we can learn from her is that from Anna is the fact that Anna, in her quest to have a well-lived life, is not only that, but Anna, if we're going to have a well-lived life, shows us that you got to have a heart of worship. You got to have a heart of worship. See, Anna had been waiting on the Messiah for a long time.
Yeah.
And all the prayers she prayed for years were answered in just one look in the tiny face of Jesus.
Yeah.
The prophet knew that Israel's Redeemer was coming.
Yeah.
And when Mary and Joseph brought him to the temple, she knew that he had come. She recognize Jesus as the promised Messiah. And so let me tell you something. Now, if you don't know the Savior,
come on,
you won't know the Savior.
Yeah. Well, yeah. That's it.
If you don't know the Savior,
yeah,
you won't know the Savior.
Come on.
You can hang around the church day and night.
Yeah.
But if you don't have a personal relationship with Christ,
yeah,
Christ can come sit right on the pew with you.
Yeah.
And you won't know who he is.
Yeah.
You could even do a whole lot of work for the church.
Yeah.
And if you don't have a personal relationship, you'll miss Jesus.
Yeah.
I marvel at the fact that Anna had the type of faith and had never met Christ yet. She had never seen Christ yet, but she had something on the inside. The Bible said that Anna did not depart from the temple, but she served God with fasting and prayers day and night. Because of the culture and the custom, Anna fasted and prayed. And I'm just going to tell somebody, it's something that'll happen when you learn to turn down a plate and go down on your knees. It's something that'll change in your life. If you have a regular prayer time and a regular time of fasting, Anna fasted and Anna prayed. And the Bible said she was in the temple both day and night. But don't get me wrong, because when we see day and night, we think Anna only stayed up in the temple. But there was a way in the culture that they had church in the daytime and church in the evening time. Because sometime in between time, you got to do some work for the church. You got to do some things because you've been fasting and because you've been praying. Could she have possibly, I'm wondering if Anna could have possibly been trying to tell us something. See, Anna was a woman that believed in prayer. Her prayers over the years had expressed a longing to see God's anointed. Anna personified for us the fact that prayers of the righteous still availeth much. Spending time in the temple probably gave her an opportunity to hear the word of God on a regular, consistent basis. She couldn't say too much because she was a woman. She couldn't really go too close, but she was a woman. But if you just let me get an earshot, if you just let me get close enough, I hear what I need to hear, and I'll do what I need to do.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Could she have possibly heard them when they talked about, because they had the New Testament, could she have heard them when they talked about, for unto us a child is born?
Yeah, yeah.
Could she have heard them When they said to us, a son is given. And the government will be on his shoulders. Maybe she eavesdropping, heard him say, and they going to call him wonderful. They going to call him counselor. They going to call him mighty God. And they going to call him everlasting father and the prince of peace. I can just see Anna up in the temple that day when she overheard that. Wait a minute. I think Isaiah was talking about the son of God when he said these words. Could it possibly be? Could this be the Sunday that the baby that's over there is the child of God? I don't know. When she saw his face, I could only imagine that everything that she hoped for had come to life. She began to see that her living was not in vain. She kept the faith and remained hopeful. And today, she laid her eyes on Jesus. I want to tell somebody today, don't you give up your hope. Don't you give up your faith. You keep on worshiping God. You keep pressing your way to the temple. Because I believe that God's got a blessing and it's got your name on it. Don't you give up now. You just about there. Don't you give up now. Because God's getting ready to do something that you ain't never seen before. Because he wants you to live. And he wants you to live your life well. And the best way to live your life well is to live your life connected to God.
When she saw his face, see, the last lesson that we can learn from Anna, she told us that you got to wait on God in spite of your circumstances. And then she told us that you got to be a worshiper. And see, worship can't depend on your circumstances. You got to be a worshiper. And lastly, she told us, after I've waited on God, after I've worshiped God, and after I've seen the face of God, then I got to become a witness for God. By the Bible, to watch it. It's in here in the Bible. And I kept saying that. And see, over at my other church, y'all, we've been studying discipleship all year long. I never thought that when I looked at Anna, that she would have all of the stuff that we've been studying all year long.
My Lord.
We can hang around the church all the time. We can worship God, and that's a wonderful thing. But until you become a witness, the process ain't over yet.
That's right.
The Bible says, coming up to them at that very moment, she gave thanks to God and spoke about the child to all who were looking forward to the redemption of Jerusalem. This really should be translated. She kept on speaking. She kept on testifying. She kept on witnessing to the crowds of the arrival of the long-awaited Messiah. I can just imagine Anna. She got up out of GMBC. I was in there today. I've been coming back and forth. I've been coming Sunday after Sunday. But today up in GMBC, it's a stranger that was in town. He showed up on a Sunday morning. He was up in GMBC. And guess what? He changed my life. I believed in my heart that he was the true and living God, and I gave my life to him. And so now when I leave GMBC, I gotta tell somebody about the goodness of the Lord. See, because there's one thing about it, when you've tasted, when you've encountered, when you've been in the presence of an almighty God, when you've seen Jesus, when the Holy Ghost worked on you, you can't keep it to yourself. You got to tell somebody about the goodness of the Lord. You got to go on your job tomorrow and tell somebody, you ought to have been there. You ought to have heard what the Lord said to me. God said to me, it ain't over till it's over. God said to me, I can live and I can live my life well. And it ain't based on my money. It ain't based on bank accounts. It ain't based on the block I live on. It ain't based on the boy I'm dating. It ain't based on the girl I'm dating. But it's based on the fact that I gave my life to the true and living God. I got a glimpse of that baby that said was laying in a manger, wrapped in swaddling clothes. I got a glimpse of Jesus over in the manger.
Yeah.
Anna
I don't know how long she lived after that, but at 84 years old, the hopes of her life came to fruition in the church that Sunday morning. And I'm just telling somebody today, it happened for Anna way back then, but it can happen for you on this morning. If you just believe in the true and living God. Because see, you got to understand something. I'm talking about the baby Jesus. But Jesus grew up one day. He was a full grown man. He lived for 33 and a half long years. And in his 33 and a half long years, he lived so that you could live your life well. He lived his life well. Well, how well did he live, preacher? He lived well enough to come through 42 generations. He lived well enough to come through the streets of Jerusalem. He lived well enough until one Friday. He lived so good until one Friday. They hung him on an old rugged cross. He lived life well. They stretched him high. They stretched him wide. Put nails in his hands. Living life well. Put nails in his feet. Living life well. He stayed there all Friday till they put him in a borrowed tomb. Living life well. Stayed there all Friday, all Saturday, until Sunday morning. It was early. Sunday morning, he lived well, because he got up. He got up with all power in his hand. I'm living life well, because he got up with all power in his hand. Thank you, Anna, for hanging around the temple. Thank you, Anna, for teaching me how to wait. Thank you, Anna, for teaching me how to worship. Thank you, Anna, for showing me how to tell somebody. But I thank Jesus that he got up. He got up in my life. And I'll tell the world that he's still saving. He's still getting up. He's still making folk live life well.
What a word. A life well lived. Wait on the Lord. Wait on the Lord. Worship the Lord. And witness for the Lord. There may be one here this morning who do not know the Lord and the pardon of your sins. There may be one here this morning who do not know the Lord as your Savior. If you are here, do not know him. Do not know Jesus as the Messiah. You can leave knowing. If you're here this morning, do not know Jesus as your Savior, we invite you to come. If you're here this morning, you are saved, but you do not have a church home. And everyone needs a church home, a place to worship, and to go to heaven from. Won't you come? And if by chance you are here, you are unsaved, you are saved without a church, and maybe you just want to reconnect with God. Maybe you got tired of waiting. Maybe you realize that you have not been the best witness. And maybe you didn't realize you had so much to worship God for. You got sidetracked. Won't you come? For the Lord is waiting on you as well. If you fit any of those three categories, won't you please come? While blood is still running warm in your body, won't you come? Amen. We look around the house and it appears to be qualified, so we thank God for the message. We thank God for the messenger, amen, that delivered us a timely word. Because at the end of the day, when our dashes are complete, the question is, how well did we live? Not how long, but how well did we live?
And so we are to make it our business to live a life well lived, where we allow the Lord to use us for the time the Lord has given us. Because you can have a short life that is powerful and a long life that is useless. Amen. We thank God again for the preacher. We're going to ask, as we get ready for our benediction, to remind everyone that food is prepared for you. We're going to ask Dr. Nelson to give God's grace over the food. Amen. There's enough for everyone. No one has to run anyone over. Amen. It will be there. I promise you that. Amen. It will be there. Again, we thank God for Dr. Nelson. Amen. Amen.
Pastor says we're going to let our wonderful row of manners come first after the benediction. I'm going to do this a little different than how Pastor does it, because if you will allow me, I want to honor my pastor who is retiring. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord may lift the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace. The Lord will move by his spirit upon your life. When you rise tomorrow, whether it's a day of work or leisure, may the love of God you to support you, the peace cover you, to shield you, and the grace of God surround you to bless and keep you. In the name of the Father, name of the Son, and the name of the Holy Spirit. May the Lord watch between me and thee while we're absent from one another. This we pray in Jesus' name. Go in peace. God bless you.
Discouraged, but not defeated, cast down, but not destroyed. There are times I don't understand, but I believe it's turning around for me. I've had struggles and disappointment. There are times I felt so alone. Some of my friends, they let me down, but I still believe it's turning around for me. Around for me.